This is just the start. Let me try to introduce a little bit what is going happening around the Dnipro. It is a real spin-off of ITC. Last year in Berlin, there was the lady from the Dnipro, Julia Svobodnova, and she was there and she spoke about the center of the Blavatsky Museum. This is the original birthplace of Blavatsky. It was held by the family for many years. She was growing up, I think, till 11 or 12. And so this is almost original, because it is in the many years it is changed a bit, and so on, and so on. The good thing is that it is now in the city recognized as an official museum. And that means that the city is also taking care of it. So it is run by a director, and she handled 5 museums, and this is just one of them. And the intention is to do a renovation, try to bring it back in the original shape, as it was in Blavatsky's time. And on the moment, you can see it as a type of museum. Although, maybe from museum point of view, it is, of course, not very polished inside. One of the reasons, and that you will see on the film as well, is the city is investigating what was the original structure of the house. And to make that visible, they have taken here and there some plaster off the wall to see the original structures of doors and so on. And that is what they have in mind to bring back. So it looks from this point a little bit more worse than it really is. So, yeah. Yeah, but you have to know what is going on. You see also markers with it and codes and so on. They have bring everything very much on maps. And so I think the next step will be that it starts to do something. But in the meantime, you can visit this. It is a real museum. And maybe it is a good moment to run the video now. Yes, it works. This entering the building. This was a first shot to see a little bit how the instrument was working. We rented very special people in to be a little bit of a live impression. Yeah. So we were flying over there with 5 people from our organization, bringing all our equipment with us: video, lamps, cameras, tripods. Yeah. But here you see all the documents. They have 4,000 documents from that period. And what you see on the wall is all prints. The originals are in safe. And what you have also noticed, of course, there is no description yet. And one of the things we have discussed over there is how to open up this center. Because there is a lot of information there. Special from historical point of view, that is very nice. But there is also something to explore more, like in the terms how to integrate all the traveling of Blavatsky during that period and after. Yeah, how to make a relation with all the publications and teachings. So, and that makes it more dynamic. So the intention is to make this a museum, but also what I called a Blavatsky universum. And that is family around her, sisters, letters from sisters, small documents describing how Blavatsky was, and so on, in old Russian. John Knievel knows all the problems around that. And so there is a lot of a real big treasure on information from the woman who starts our society. So, and to open up that Blavatsky Museum is the museum aspect, that is the historical thing, of course, adding on the things I just mentioned, but also try to establish a type of science institute to make a relation between theosophy and science. More or less what we have done the last day today and what we will do tomorrow, to see where is theosophy standing, yeah? For instance, I had just a nice discussion over dinner about theosophy and art. Yeah, there's also an important aspect. So, Johanna was there first, my wife, on the 21 of March. This lady in Berlin was really getting our leg and was pulling and say, no, you have to come and you have to do this and you have to do that. Ladies in Russian are very powerful, I can tell you. Yeah, I was hesitating. And yeah, you have to come as well. You have to do something on the university and so on. And what we will do, we arrange for you a special evening around our, let's say, music and dancing. And I say, oh my God, if this is true, I will never go. Yeah. So that is what I skipped from the program. So Johanna was there and give a lecture for one day about education from, let's say, theosophical point Loma point of view. Had another day with the lectures with the ladies and study. I was there on the 8th of May, White Lotus, was in the university. I have given there a theosophical lecture. The requirement was really on science level, so I've done my best. Maybe I have done a too good job, but okay, we will see in future how that works out. And so we were working there. Vic was there from the Philippines. Isis Recent was there from Brazil, so there were all some people around it. And by discussing on the end of that event the next day, we had a discussion and say, yes, but you should try to focus now how to open up, how to make it more international known. And you have seen one of the things that has to be done is no information. Yeah, we have only Russian information. Yeah, if you want to open up international, you should at least do English as well. So we say to them, make your text in Russian, no problem. We make it English, you check it. If it is okay, we make nice displays what it means. Yeah. So we were for 2.5 days were filming, making photos, and we promised then to make short PR activities, showing short videos, and we will also try to make a type of internet setup, a homepage, what is interactive, so you can click on documents and can see more information. That in the last one is still quite a job, but at least we make a start with it and try to explore it and see how it will look like and what type of possibilities it will give there. The ladies applied for a visa to be here. That is Julia Swabanova and Tanjana, to be here, but they were refused to have a visa, so that was impossible. And they asked me, do you want to say something about the Dnipro? So it is now on the internet. There is a witness that I have done my best. And they sent a letter, and Laribel will address it letter to you. Yep. And then afterwards, I have some additional things.
Okay, so if you allow me a small minute, because I actually have two things. Let's see. because the lady sent a small email to Johanna, which is actually pretty nice to read as well. They say, "Dear friends and brothers, we wish you fruitful work and search for the truth. It doesn't matter that we can only see you through the online broadcast. It's important that we are together on a subtle level. May our common efforts in search of the truth help us to become wiser for the sake of the evolution of all mankind, and at last, or at least, the whole of our solar system. With fraternal greetings and with love, Julia and Tatiana." So they are watching, so maybe we can wave to them. I have no idea which camera, but maybe just all of them. So that was part one. As Herman said, I also have a letter, which I will read to you. This is addressed to all of you. So, dear friends, since 1990, in the city of Dnipro, Ukraine, efforts are underway to create the museum center of H.P. Blavatsky and her family. The idea united like-minded people, representatives of various state and public organizations. The Dmytro Yavornitsky, my Russian is not so good, National Historical Museum of Dnipro became the starting point for its realization. The government of Ukraine adopted a number of decisions supporting the project. In the course of systematic work on the implementation of the project, three leading forces joined together: academics, theosophists, and culturologists. Workstream leaders have created a public coordination center called the Universum of Helena Blavatsky, which works in many directions. Since 2005, the place of work of these like-minded people has become an old mansion of the territory of the city manor, which in 1815 till 1834 belonged to the grandfather of H.P. Blavatsky. She was born in this manor in 1831 on July 31, according to the Julian calendar, and August 12, according to our current calendar. Scientific concept of the museum center of H.P. Blavatsky and her family was developed and approved, of which the author was E.V. Alivanseva. Having undergone several stages of reflection, it is now the project of creating an international center museum. A single concept and a common strategy make this two-vector project simultaneously headed towards the past and the future. The museum will carry out its activities in the reconstructed historic manor and its main house. Next to it will be the center of H.P. Blavatsky. These buildings will be united with a single garden and park area of 2 hectares. The museum and manor are memorial complex, historical, cultural, natural heritage. The center of H.P. Blavatsky is the place of contemporary thinking on the heritage of an outstanding citizen of the world. This project includes 3 vectors for the development of a new type of organization: museum, center, and the association of like-minded people, which reflects in 3 main goals, of which the first one is restoration of the building and the creation of a museum exposition dedicated to H.P. Blavatsky and 3 generations of her family. The second is reconstruction of the historical manor of Fadiv, the place in which the early childhood of H.P. Blavatsky passed, and recreation of a unique garden of fruit trees and flowers on the territory of the manor, as well as a pavilion, which it will be an exhibition hall and auditorium, and a wing for children's programs and such. The third goal will be the creation of an international center for the study of works of H.P. Blavatsky, work with the public, comprehending her heritage, arrangement of the conference hall, a scientific library, communication facilities, exhibition hall, a publishing center, guest cottages on the territory of the center. The museum center, created as a universal unifying form of art, as a holistic art and scientific work, is based on a developed system of images, signs, and symbols. This is a bridge from the past to the future, the place of transfer of H.P. Blavatsky's heritage to the society, aspiring to a spiritual search. The main goal of the museum center is the creation and implementation of programs for contemporary heritage comprehension, scientific and creative application of H.P. Blavatsky's works, and spiritual involvement of contemporaries and subsequent generations in the awareness of this evolutionary essence of the works of an outstanding thinker, writer, researcher of ancient teachings, and the founder of the Theosophical Society. Dear friends, we will be grateful for your support, cooperation, joint creation of the Museum Center of H.P. Blavatsky and her family. Signed by the members of the association Universum of H.P. Blavatsky, the people of which are Elena Alivantseva, Tatiana Golovchenko, Ludmila Sogoskina, Alina Morgunova, Julia Revenko, Julia Rodina, and Julia Shabanova.
So that spin-off was having some other important effects as well. I was attending the tour through the museum with Vic Hao-Ching in the same time. And there was a very nice document on the wall, handwritten by the sister of Helena Blavatsky. And there was a starting a very nice discussion about the translation of the document, because it was old Russian and it was quite hard for the people there to get it, translated, decoded. So there was something going on, and Vic was under the impression, Vic Hao-Ching, that he has seen already in translation. So that was another good combination in exchanging. But another important thing is, there are still some documents over there in Russian what should be translated so that it is also understandable and readable for people coming from outside the Ukraine. And being in Berlin, Julia Svobodova was having an interpreter, yeah? And that girl was living in Berlin, and that was very good in her job. And John Kniebel was there as well. And he had a nice talk with that lady, not only because she was beautiful, but also she was very good in the translation of the language. Yeah? So it works out that John was able to establish a working relation, and she is helping John now with translating the Blavatsky letters, the Russian part. Maybe you'd like to say something yourself?